All right. So we're out. I used to party with y'all and Carl and all the Chi-Town people. We always run into each other at the club. Have you seen like a celebrity that made you like stop and like, damn, that's them over there?
Yeah. I've definitely been there. It's been a couple of, you know, here's the thing about being in LA. I was talking to somebody recently about this. I can't even think. Who was I talking to? Talking to somebody. And I was like, oh, my best guy friend. And I was saying, wow, I was like, I look like Kevin Hart. And he was just jogging down the street. And he was like, yeah, you know, I saw so-and-so and such. And I said, it's interesting because although I live in LA and you see celebrities, it's like very random. You could be at Coffee Bean and you turn around and you're like, oh wait, hey Eddie Murphy, you know, like it's like that. So right. When you have those kind of situations, it's quite interesting. But for me, I knew I was going to meet this celebrity and it still freaked me out. And this is the story I always tell, was Prince.
Wow. Prince is at Coffee Bean jogging down the street.
he was jogging down the street with his coffee in his hand. No, I saw him actually. I was invited, a friend of mine invited me to his home, and he does like these impromptu jam sessions. Okay. And he's just playing his guitar, he's playing, performing with a band, and you know, and so at his house is where I, you know, you just, first of all, you have to wrap your mind around the whole idea that I know somebody who know Prince, number one. Right. And then it's like, you know, this is a man who I have adored since Adore came out.
Right.
You know
right,
what I'm saying?
Right, right.
So
we're going to use another word, which is that, you know, adore. No, go ahead.
I mean, I know the lyrics to Darling Nikki, like, before I knew what he was talking about, but before I even knew what it was about, I was like, this is my jam. My name is Nikki, Darling Nikki, like, this is just serendipity, you know?
You are like I'm not gonna say it. You were young when that song came out, and that song is really nasty. But that's your song. My mother, like, you can't listen to that song. Like, what's wrong with that song, Mom? You don't can't listen to that song. That's the cut. Now, you brought me to the movie to see this. I'm going to stay on my bike. You bringing me out to the movies to see this, and you getting mad and covering my eyes when Apollonia is naked? I'm sorry. Go back. But he's all Prince. Did he do the song for you specially, or what?
What'd you say? I didn't hear you.
Did he do the song for you? Like I'm going to dedicate this to you, all the niggas out there. all the niggas out there. There's 20 people in a jam session. I'm going to dedicate this to you.
No. There was no dedication to the Nickies in the audience.
Wow.
But what I thought was interesting was, and this is where I'm headed to your question about the celebrity thing,
right,
is the number of celebrities that appear to be as awestruck as I was about being in. And maybe they weren't, but from my perspective, it was everybody from Diddy to Superhead was at his house. And they were all, it was almost like, wow, we're all in awe over this genius, over this guy, this man who at some point of our lives impacted us. So, you know, Dr. Phil, and you just see all these people, and you're like, in one room.
Whoa, back up.
Hold on.
Dr. Phil?
Dr. Phil.
I'm tripping.
He actually stepped on my foot. And I was like, I looked down, because, you know, I'm from the shower. I was like, damn, dog. Yeah. Oh, hey, what are you doing?
You don't step on my feet, though. Come on.
You stepped on my shine. Oh, dude. Yeah.
Like, oh, cool. Yeah, you stepped on my shine.
We're going to get in. We're going to get there. Slow down. You know, relax. You know what I mean? We ain't going to miss the show.
I just love Darling Nikki. I don't want to miss it. Yeah, crazy. Superhead was there.
Yeah, that's what tripped me out too. Wait a minute.
Corinne Stephens, what year was this? 02 or something when she was hot?
Nah, that had to be like 2000. No, no, no.
This was actually much. This was later. This was later. Yeah, this was later. This was not. This was like in 07, 08 or something like this. Was later. I don't. I can't remember exactly when, but yeah, this was after the book. Oh. This was much after the. This was a few years after the book.
She was trying to ask.
I mean, it was
chapters.
Enough for me to know, recognize who she is, and for me to say, oh, okay, that's Corinne Stephens.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. I don't even know where to go after Dr. Phil and Superhead.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
That's it. Yeah. But oh, you got
how
a chance.
Segue.
No. Yeah, I can do it. No, I want to say this though. The celebrity I met that was weird when I was living in LA. Was Lawrence Fishburne. I thought it was the weirdest thing ever because I'm in the gas station. I reach in my pocket, some change fall on the ground. I reach down to get it. I look to see who's behind me. It was Lawrence Fishburne in a trench coat. I said, hey, man, Lawrence Fishburne. He's like, what's up? How are you? I'm like, how you doing? Morpheus, damn. I'm pumping my gas, looking at him like, it's Morpheus over there. That's how you turn it, And that's me from Cornbread Early Me. That's him.
So was he was cordial and nice.
He was obviously. Cool. He was real cool. Real cool.
From living in LA, don't you find it interesting when you see a celebrity who is black and they act like you're wasting their time by even acknowledging who they are, or they don't even want you to see them? They do that whole, I'm going to look down because I don't want you to see that it's me, or I'm with my glasses. Right. Or maybe I could hide the fact that you might know me. Right. Don't you think that's interesting?
Brian McKnight.
He was an asshole?
Brian McKnight. Yeah. He does that.
Oh, really?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I don't get that. I don't understand. I don't understand where that stems from. I'm not quite sure. I mean, there are people who have met. I didn't have the pleasure of meeting him personally.
Oh, no, I did.
But you know, there are people who met Michael Jackson for the very first time, and he literally would still say, hi, my name is Michael. You know, I just think it's interesting that there is some people feel inclined to allow that quote-unquote celebrity label to dictate the way that they interact socially with the public. You know, it's to me, it's always, I'm like, you're choosing to do that. Like, you're making a conscious choice. And I've been around a lot of different celebrities of, you know, from A-list to D-list, right, and just see how they interact with their fans or the public, and it's really interesting.
Yeah, I seen R. Kelly at the Evergreen Plaza in Chicago, which is not there anymore. I should take pictures and send it to you because it's not there. They tore it down like crazy. I'm like, oh man. Anyway,
so what's there now?
Nothing
what's
there yet.
Now?
It's just a big
it's
bunch
a
of dirt.
It's a vacant lot.
It's a vacant lot. I think they're building a whole house or something like that.
Yeah, they built a whole new one.
Wow.
But I was in Sam Goody.
Oh, wow.
Sam Goody. And it was early in the morning, about 11 o'clock in the morning. Me and my buddy in there buying some tape. And R. Kelly was in there.
Mm-hmm.
It's me, my buddy, R. Kelly, his two bodyguards, and this lady and her two kids. Two kids walked over to R. Kelly and like, hey, can we get an autograph? It wasn't like it was a mob of people. It was 11 o'clock in the morning.
Right.
R. Kelly looked down and he told the guy, no, he don't. He whispered something to the guy, no, he didn't want to do autographs right now. This was like right before 12 play came out. I'm like, you were still with public announcement.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, sign them damn autographs for them kids, man. Come on, man. That was disappointing.
Yeah, that was foul.
But, hey, well.
Yeah. I had a situation. I ain't gonna even call this person.
Oh my god!
No, you gotta put it out here now. Come on now,
R. Kelly back in 2000. It's up to you. You want to tell that story? Is it something crazy?
It's up to you if you want to call him out. I went to a fundraiser. The tickets were $2,500.
That's
not no fundraiser. That's a car note.
That's a car note between the bucks. That's a nice used car.
You'll be riding a Ford Taurus for 3 years for $2,500.
Exactly. And
see, I can't play that good enough. Yeah.
Go ahead.
Very expensive fundraiser. About two tickets, because it was for Chicago to benefit It was a foundation in Chicago to benefit people in Chicago. And I literally was like, you know what, I've done like fundraisers and I've done some charity work and contributions to some things out here, but I couldn't really find anything in Chicago that spoke to me. So I said, you know what, I respect this brother. I'm going to contribute to his foundation.
Right on.
I never even got a chance to meet Common.
Oh.
He literally, it was literally a performance.
Wow.
And he came on stage, performed Glory, and then went right back up to the VIP. And I was just, I couldn't believe it. He did Glory.
So this happened just what, last year? This was before the Oscars or?
He couldn't drop a melody.
This was after the Oscar.
He couldn't drop like at least three more tracks? You know what I'm saying? Like, come on. No. That's it, dog? No, he would have
done.
Wow.
Yeah.
500.
Well, yeah, I was. It was in Chicago. It was almost like, am I in Los Angeles? Because it was a very Hollywood move. Like, it was something to me that I just felt like, is this is Chicago? And so you know you're catering to a completely different demographic. And obviously, you know, the tickets alone is not general admission. You know, it wasn't a private. It wasn't a public affair. It was a private party. So everybody, majority of the people that were there contributed some money, and that's a lot of money. And I was like, you know how many foundations I could have given this money to? And I just was, I was disappointed. I was quite disappointed considering, and not even that I wanted to necessarily meet him, but I just felt like you should at least engage with your donor.
Right.
Because next year you're going to still be looking for these contributors. You know, you want us to contribute to your foundation, right?
Right.
Let me feel like my money is appreciated because I work hard for my money. Listen, I'm driving an old Benz. You know what I'm saying? That work is very expensive on my car.
When
it
breaks down, I can't even find the parts. So you better shake my hand, Connor.
Wow.
Exactly.